Hello everyone, welcome back to Coding with T. Today we are going to learn how to reduce the number of rebuilds using dot select feature of Riverpod. Sometimes while coding, you might have come across with a situation that we have a list of items. Let's say we have 100 or 1000 list of items on the screen and you want to only change the one checkbox or just want to change or toggle something. Most probably you will see a jank on the screen, means that the list got updated but it took few seconds to change its state. So for that, definitely we need to find a way out that we cannot rebuild the whole list, rather we only want to change the item or the element that is being updated. So how we can do that? So this is what we are going to learn in today's tutorial. As you can see, we are creating a Riverpod complete crash course. I'll drop the link down below in the description of this complete playlist, or you can also get it from the right top corner. So without wasting time, let's get towards tutorial. Those who are following, they know that we have created all the tutorials in proper sections. So, and all the source code is already available and link is in the description of its GitHub repository. So now this is the video 11th, and in this we are going to do the two examples. The first one is very simple. We will use the simple select using a model. So first of all, I'm going to create a state provider that is going to change its states, but we are going to use a to-do model, simple select provider. And as we are going to use state provider that we already covered in the previous tutorials, so we have the ref object, and then in this function what we are going to return, we are going to return the model that we already created, which is a to-do model, and I'm going to give some default values over here, and let's value to true, control alt l. So we have a state provider and which is actually returning simply one to-do item, and we are going to use this to-do to see what we can achieve or how we are going to achieve only single change. So let's create a screen. We're going to use the consumer widget. I'm going to name it simple select demo. Okay, without going into the widget itself, because we have to first listen to the provider that we created above. So as usual in the previous tutorials, that so far what we have learned, let's say we only want to focus on the boolean variable, which is the completed of to-do list. So I'm going to name it completed is equal to reference dot watch, and as in the previous practice, you know that we just have to copy this, and whenever there is change inside this provider, means the whole to-do list, whenever this whole to-do list or any item in this to-do model is going to be changed, our front end or the UI will redraw itself, because we are listening to this complete model. So whatever this specific provider is returning, in this case it is just returning a one single to-do item, we will actually redraw the screen. But what we are going to achieve, we only want to redraw the screen when the change is inside this completed. So how we can do that? You see, we have called the provider, and then we have a feature called select, and in the select, because it is a function, so we have to create a selector, something like this, or you can create a function itself. We have item or just a simple to do. So over here we are going to call the item dot completed. So we only listening to this specific completed item. So whenever we are going to change this specific item, now this watch is actually watching the specific field only. Now drop down over here, we are using this completed in a checkbox. If the value is completed, checkbox will definitely redraw, and using onChange method, we are again using the same provider over here. We're going to read it for the only one time, and using reference.read we will call the notifier, and to update its state we will use simply t.copyWith method that we already learned in the previous tutorials of to do, that whenever we want to only change one value, we will definitely return the whole model, because we want to stay immutable, and for that we have t.copyWith. We are only changing this completed value. So the new state will be stored inside this state, and in this case state is to do model. So this to do model will be updated with the new value, with the new value of completed. If it is true, then it will be false, and vice versa, because it is being toggled. Now at the top, if you also want to display the title, because in this case we're just returning or just focusing on the completed. So if you also want to display the title, you just have to read it only one time, because we are not changing the title here. We are only changing, or we are only going to redraw our screen when one single item is going to be changed. So let's say we have the title, but we are going to read it only one time for the first time. And because we have a read option, so directly we can call title like this. Now we have the title only because it is read. We will only get it for the first time when this widget is going to be built and completed, whenever definitely we are watching it. So whenever this completed value is going to be changed, we will get the new value and this widget should be redrawn. Okay, so let me run this. So make sure to add that screen in the main.draw dart and choose the Chrome to run it. Okay, our application is running, but we have an error because we was unable to add scaffold. So let's rerun it again. And this time you can see we only have a checkbox and a title. So we have a title at the top. The title says create video 11th of Riverpod Clash. Creating. We have the completed over here. So when we are going to redraw this, you see it is being redrawn, but we want to make sure that only the checkbox is being updated, or if there is anything else that we are also listening to. So let me print rebuild in this build method, and also let's create just another checkbox. Instead of changing the completed, we are going to change the title to video 11th is completed. Let's rerun it. So we have two checkboxes. The second checkbox should change the title and the first checkbox should rewrite the checkbox itself. So we have two rebuilds at the start. So let me toggle it again. You can see another rebuild. If I'm going to click on this, you see it is also not updating because we are changing the title text, because title text is fixed at the top. We read it only once. So this is also not being updated, but also we do not have any rebuild. So rebuild only occurs. You see, when rebuild occurs, video 11th is completed appears on the screen because that was also changed, but the build or the rebuild was not occurred due to ref.read. So by this way, you only know that we are listening to the specific item. Now to save the time, I've created another same example, which is select list. So we are going to use the to-do list over here, but we have two items on the two sides. So first of all, let me copy and replace it in the main.dart. Okay, as you can see, we have application running, and on the left side we have without select, and on the right side we have with select. So we're going to compare these both, but first let's try to understand how we are going to manage these both. So first of all, we have compare select screen, and on the left we have expanded in a row, and on the right we also have an expanded, but the title says with select on the right and without select on the left. So we have two widgets, to-do list without select. So first of all, let's talk about this. So we have ref.watch on this widget, on this specific consumer widget. We are watching to the to-do list provider. So if I'm going to go to the to-do list provider, if you remember the video 7th, where we have created the to-do model, and also we created this notifier, to-do list notifier. We have the toggle, remove, and add methods, three methods that we created at that time. And we also created a simple, if you focus on this provider, we created a simple to-do provider, which was at the start, or when the application runs, it was returning an empty list. It was something like this. But now to return fixed number of values, I have just created list.generate, which is the 10 items. To-do will have the ID. ID will go like 1, 2, 3 up to 10, and then task number completed if the modulus of whatever value divide or mod of 3 is equal to 0, that specific value will be completed. We have 10 items in the list, and we are returning that list or using that list on the front end. So if we go back, we are simply calling that to-do provider. We have hard-coded to-dos, 10 items. We are using length, and we are printing the to-do one by one using this specific item, which is simply displaying without select features. So we have a to-do over here. We are simply using the notifier because we want to toggle the checkbox, right? So this is nothing new, a simple widget, a simple listener, and that's it for the without select. If you have any questions, you can definitely ask me. But on the right side with select, you can see we are not targeting, or we are not watching the specific provider that we created, but rather because we also need to know the length of the list. So for that, I just created a new provider, a simple provider, which is simply watching the list of, the length of the to-do list provider, the provider above. So actually what this is doing, this is a kind of computed widget that we learn in the previous tutorial. So we use this to only get the length. We're watching the previous tutorial, we have 10 items, but if we're going to add more items in the length, we will be having a new length using this provider. So just to use the length, we have the length over here. We printed the length, to-do list with select. So parent rebuild length is equal to whatever the length of this specific list. Then we have the item builder. We get the title using this I method because it is list view. So we have title, we have ID, and we are simply passing them to the next list, which is actually printing it. And here we have the select reference.watch. We are watching the to-do list provider again, but not the whole to-do list. Again, if you are confused, we are just using this as a number of items in the list, and it can be rebuilt when list items are going to be changed. Let's say we are going to remove the list or we are going to add item in the list. So this is going to redraw itself because we have a new item in the list. So nothing else. Next, in order to get the completed value, you see completed value of each item, we are simply calling to-do list provider dot select. We have the complete list over here. If you see, we have a list of to-dos, and on each list of to-do, because we pass the to-do ID, so based on the to-do ID, we will get the first where it is completed. Means we are only focusing on the completed value from the whole list, and whenever the completed is going to redraw, this specific widget should be redrawn and we should be able to see this specific line. Okay, I have run the application, and on the screen currently you can see we have two lists, and for the first time in the application build itself on the console, you can see we have without select build all the items from 0 to 9 and with select also build all the items with from 0 to 9 with the completed as true and false. Now let's say I'm going to remove this toggle value. It is going to toggle the both items because we have the same list. So let's toggle it. But this time you see without select the left side rebuild all the items from 0 to 9 means all the 10 items in the list redraw itself again. So that's why we have the print statement which is saying that all the list is being built. But on the right side you can see only one item, which is at item 0 and completed value changed to false. The only item which is being built on the right side is this. So let's see it again. You see again all the items built on the left, only one item on the right. So same way, if I'm going to change this, this time you can see item 1 completed to true, nothing else. If we go for the last item, so it is the item 9 completed false, but on the other hand without select all the items are being built. So I'm going to add the to do over here. So new task is added, but for the new task you can see all the without select and all the with select items are being updated. But when I'm going to change this specific field, again the item 10 in the list and completed to true was changed. So this is the power of select. If you have any question or any confusion, you can ask me down below in the comments. So that's it for today's tutorial. If you learned something new, please like the video, and if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified for all the upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching and take care.